another session of NEET PG High Yield MCQ discussion. Today we will see about carpal tunnel syndrome. See, what is the question? So, which of the following nerve is involved in carpal tunnel syndrome? Straightforward question, NEET PG pattern. Okay. So, given options are radial nerve, median nerve, ulnar nerve and posterior intraosseous nerve. So, what is the answer? It's median nerve, right? So, the correct answer is median nerve. So, we will see in detail about this. See, this is a cut section at the level of wrist. You see here, it's the median nerve just below the carpal, just below the flexor retinaculum, which is white in color. You see here, this is the flexor retinaculum, this is the flexor retinaculum. So, flexor, just below the flexor retinaculum, median nerve is there. So, it is more prone to compression if there is hypertrophy of the flexor retinaculum or any mechanical compression at that area will lead on to the compression of the median nerve. See, here the median nerve is accompanied by a lot of tendons. See, if you see here, it is very closely related to FPL tendon, flexor pollicis longus tendon, and flexor digitorum profundus tendons, flexor digitorum superficialis tendons. Okay. So, these are the structures of carpal tunnel. These are all the structures of the carpal tunnel. If you see here, flexor carpi radialis tendon, no? It's piercing the flexor retinaculum and it's going inside. Whereas, palmaris longus, ulnar artery and ulnar nerve, they are traveling outside the flexor retinaculum. So, they are less prone to compression type of injuries. So, median nerve, as it passes below the flexor retinaculum, it is more prone for compression type of injuries. So, if you are going to read subjects like anatomy, you better have a standard textbook with you. Whatever you read, you just reinforce your knowledge by revising through the standard textbooks. Okay, we will see with some other high yield discussion. Thank you.